as a mother, having those overwhelming days is not a matter of if, but when. And when that overwhelming starts to sink in, this is the time we need to shift our focus and just remind ourselves of just who you are. And that is a child of God, the child of the one true King, our dear friend Jesus. The sooner we remember that, the sooner we'll start to take each moment day by day. Sacred Queens, thank you so much for tuning in for another video. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Maggie and I do all types of spiritual care videos. So if that's something you may be interested in, please consider subscribing so that you never miss another upload. But if you're just here for the title, then yep, today I am offering some words of encouragement for some of us just overwhelmed moms out there, because I know I'm not the only one. As you guys know, I am a mother of four. Yes, count them, four. And with quarantine and then the summer kind of creeping up on us, yes, those overwhelming days are starting to be more than none, okay? But honestly, guys, when I do start to feel those days coming on, or, you know, during those days, you know, when things are just a little hectic, things are just a little chaotic, you know, sometimes they can get out of control and I, you know, they can really try me, test mama, but it's okay. Because I've really been trying to like check myself and really trying to lead with peace and lead with love, just like Jesus did, of course. So that's what today's video is going to be all about. Just some scriptures that I think can be very helpful, very encouraging and inspiring to probably some of us moms to help us kind of get back centered when those chaotic days seem to creep up on us, all right? So my first scripture is out of John 14:1, and I love what it says. And it says, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God, trust also in me." So don't let your hearts be troubled. Don't let your hearts be overwhelmed. Obviously, we want to take it one diaper, one tantrum, one day at a time, and don't let our hearts be troubled. So that one I like to keep near me on my desk as well. Oh, I love this one in Ephesians 6:10, and it says, "Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power." So it's saying be strong in the Lord, not from our own strength. Obviously, that's getting us nowhere. Obviously, we're being defeated by little toddlers every day. So God is saying to be strong in the Lord and his mighty power, right? We get all that strength and all that power, right? And that resilience from him, right? So that's another one I love to keep, you know, in the back of my mind. Oh, I love this one also in Psalm 61:2, and it says, "From the end of the earth I will cry to you," right? How many of us have been crying all week because of these children? "When my heart is overwhelmed, from the end of the earth, I will cry to you when my heart is overwhelmed. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Lead me to the throne. Lead me to the scripture. You know, lead me to the person, the Savior that is stronger than I, who can put me back in good spirits, who can lift me out of that overwhelmment," right? And I just love how these scriptures still relate to us this day. "From the end of the earth, I will cry to you." That means when we're overwhelmed, when we're frustrated, yes, we should definitely be crying and, you know, seeking God in those moments, right? And he will lead us to the rock that is higher than us, right? Which is his word, which is his promise. Okay, mom, so the joy in the Lord is our strength, okay? And the sooner that we believe that and try to always try to like come back to that, and that's seriously when I take time, I like to come into my little room. I use that time in the car, you know, when I seriously just need a second, you know, take it to my car, find the closest coffee shop or, you know, snack place I can find, you know, and just really, really get back centered, guys. Because I've noticed that when I don't take that time to bring it back down, it's just on 10, it's on 10, it's on 10, you know. And obviously we don't want that, a reaction or whatever. And this is for anything. I just keep mentioning the kids because yes, they butts, oh man, they be trying me. No, my kids are angels. No, I'm just joking. But this can be any overwhelming situation, right? Work, your marriage, you know, it's all about finding that groundness and getting back centered, so that we can know how to react in the way that Christ would, if that makes sense. Moving on to Numbers 24-26, and this one's a little wordy but very powerful, guys. "The Lord will bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious. The Lord will lift you up, his countenance upon you, and give you peace." The moment that we seek him, right? The moment that we're crying out to him and that we just give him our all, right? We give him the problem, we bring it to him, right? We lay it all on the table, essentially, for him. The moment that we do that, the Lord will make his face to shine upon us and to be gracious. How many of us have really, you know, been in that mood or that mode where, you know, we're weeping or we're tired, we're overwhelmed, we're frustrated, you know, we just finally take that moment and that time to just sought out God and his, you know, and his comfort, right? And then almost instantly, right, we feel renewed, we feel refreshed, we feel calmer, right? We feel comforted, you know, and in his word. And that's just another confirmation that the Lord will lift us up in his countenance upon you and give us that peace that we've been needing, right? Because we can only get that from him. Ooh, guys, what about this one? In Psalms 138, and it says, "The Lord will fulfill his purpose for me. You steadfast love, O love, endures forever." Yes. "Do not forsake the work of your hands." Do not forsake all the work that you do morning, evening, nighttime. You know what I'm saying? Morning, afternoon, evening. You know, do not discredit yourself. Do not feel like, you know, the work that you do is being unnoticed. You know, maybe you're a single mother. Maybe you are married and, you know, you don't have as much help still. God is saying, do not let up. Do not, you know, use that as an excuse to do less. No, do more, because God is always watching. God is always, you know, calculating. He's always putting it together. He's always watching us and building up those blessings. And actually, I should say, storing up those blessings in heaven for us. So do not forsake the work of your hands, because it's never going unnoticed. As we see those sleepless nights, he sees those sleepless nights. He sees you watching, making breakfast, lunch, dinner every single day. He sees you working and cleaning out the thing out little noses and little feet and little bums all day. It says he sees your work. So do not forsake the work of your hands. Wow. Also in Isaiah 41:10, guys, these are so powerful. These are the scriptures I hold. These are so powerful. Like, these really hit home to me, especially when I need to get out of that funk. And, you know, I just keep them written down. I have them in my journal already. And it's called overwhelming. And as soon as I get to that mode, guys, like, I just literally open my journal and I just kind of remind myself and fill my spirit up with these scriptures, guys. Especially Isaiah 41:10. "Fear not, for I am with you. Fear not, for he is always with us. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. I will uphold you. I will honor you. I will bless you." "I will strengthen you." But we cannot be dismayed. We cannot be discouraged, guys. I know it's hard. I had a hard week myself, trust me. But, you know, the older I feel like the kids are getting, you know, the more strategic they're getting, you know. And yes, guys, I still have those days. Trust me, I'm not perfect. I'm far from it, you know. But that's what my ministry and kind of like my fellowship is all about. Just kind of reminding ourselves and reminding each other that we are not perfect. And the more the merrier, you know, the more that we uplift each other and hold each other accountable or really inspire each other and be there for each other, really, the better off that we can be. And I think that's how, and I think Jesus really enjoys that type of fellowship as well, especially with us women, especially nowadays in the godless world that we live in. You know, I think fellowshipping and really, really building those communities, building that army, God says, you know, for him is what's going to essentially defeat the enemy in the end. We will rejoice, we will celebrate, you know, from all of the praise, all of the good things that we are doing in the world today, right? So that's why I think these scriptures are very important. And I absolutely love this last scripture in Matthew 11:28, and it says, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." So he's saying, come to us, all who are overwhelmed, all who labor, all who work all day, all night. Come to me and I will give you rest, guys. I definitely noticed a big difference when I kind of wind down with my Bible study or with some, you know, some type of book, just something to get me back in good spirits, especially after a long day of work, guys. Like, I always feel the most peaceful and the most restful when I, you know, just thank him for my job. Thank him for all the hard work that we have to do, you know, honor it, you know, do it with honor and respect, you know, and all that good stuff. So Matthew 11:28 is definitely one of my favorites. It just reminds us that we can always rest no matter how hard we work, no matter how many hours we work. We can always have that nice, peaceful, well-rested, you know, 8-hour rest in the comfort of the Lord, right? So that's all the encouragement I have today, moms. I hope this has really, really helped us to get back in good spirits. Just know that we can take back our household. We can take back our emotions and not let it, you know, kind of affect us or continue to make us overwhelmed. Remember that we always have a special place in God's heart, a special place to come to, which is this word. word, which will almost always instantly just get us back in that mommy like mood, right? So all right, you guys, that's all I have for this video. I really hope it's helpful. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in another video. Peace.